hating on you with their friends, girl, you got it.
Hi, welcome to Beautiful Snow TV, and welcome back, Snowflakes, and welcome if you guys are new. I know it looks kind of wonky, and it's not the usual setup. I had to remove some footage, guys. The quality of that footage was horrible. So you're going to see in the product list below, in the description, of all the products I did use. I do apologize about not the usual startup or intro, but I'm just going to go ahead and get right into the nail set. So we have our peel-off base coat on. Make sure you guys hit the subscribe button. Make sure you hit the bell notification so you don't miss another time when I upload. I have to just get that apology in there for you guys, but we're going to go ahead and get into the nail set as we already are halfway through. So we're going to go ahead and get into this. This is some pink polygel from Model Ones. It's a beautiful color. So I am just showing you guys what I'm doing here. I'm just going in. I have my, these are some 3XL coffin tips. I did just clip the tip off. I have pre-shaped these as well. And I also have on my peel off base coat as always to create content for you guys. So with this set, I wanted to do some fruit nails. I know it's really popular right now, and I think y'all are probably tired of seeing fruit nails because they're like everywhere. Like all my favorite YouTubers, content creators, and Instagram, they're everywhere. So I just decided I want to put my little input on there. So I've been wanting to do these for a while, for about a month or so, and I just, you know, I'm like, let me get some of these products and really do my take on it. Mine is a little bit more simple, but I still want to like some razzle dazzle, but something that you don't see on it every day. Each set that I see is really, really cute. It's different. It has that content creator's like personality in the set. And that's really what nails is. It's just art, you know, individual art, you know, tailored to you. So this is my take on the fruit nails, and we're gonna go ahead and cap all of these with clear. So I just wanted to kind of bring that out because I almost forgot about it. So we're just gonna go ahead with the regular ombre effect. So we're gonna do our tip first. It's my way of doing my ombres. I do my tip first, and then I go ahead and poly my poly gel like I always do with my cuticle pusher, and then I always do it with the brush to kind of smooth it over. And then once I'm done with that, I cure each nail for a full 60 seconds, as well as doing like, you know, making sure my sides are like nice and straight. Like the cuticle pusher is really, really good for that. Like, see that? Like, you want to, the trick to keeping your shape, like if you have pre-shaped nails or even if you're shaping yourself, the trick to keeping your shape is getting those sides. Y'all got to get those sides. Like you want the nail to keep its shape. If you're really bad at your application, and this is go back to application, you have to practice this. If you're really bad at that, then, you know, just kind of work on it. It doesn't happen overnight. You know, I've been doing my nails for 3 years now. It did not happen overnight. Y'all can see the growth, but I learned to like keep the shape of the nail. Like the tip is really more of a guide. Now, people that know how to use dual, like forms, like, you know, the paper forms, they are beasts. I just don't think I could use a form. I probably could if I tried, and I really got it, like, you know, a few times, but tips are just really my easier, faster way to go for me. Some people use dual forms, some people use other stuff, but tips are just really, you know, it's pre-shaped tips at that are just really my go-to. Now, I have started to really kind of pre-shape my tips, like the duck nails I just did, the Louis Vuitton duck nails. Those I pre-shape those. Duck tips, I feel like you gotta pre-shape before you put them on, especially if you're doing a pop-off method. Now, here I'm just rambling, guys, while y'all watch me do this application. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this purple. And I also want to make sure each poly gel is like a jelly. I didn't want it to be so see-through, so pigmented, but it's still pigmented, but they're still almost like jelly poly gels. And I really, really like that feature. I will have all the products that I use in this video linked down below. Make sure you guys hit the Amazon storefront, because all these products are always in my Amazon storefront. Because whatever I order from Amazon, I automatically just go ahead and put it in my Amazon storefront for you guys. So you'll know what products I used and, you know, where they came from. So yeah, I always try to make sure I do that for you guys, just in case you guys want to try to get those products and use them for whatever set you're going to use them for. Now here, we did go ahead and start with the application of the gel polishes. So I don't use acrylic. So the way I wanted to incorporate some glitters, I didn't want to use like messy glitter. I have it. I just didn't want to pull it out. This is easier. So I also have my little fruit slices here because we're doing encapsulations today. So with this, I just got like the thinnest ones I could find. Each fruit on each nail, I had got the thinnest ones I could find because you didn't want it to be too bulky and you didn't want the nails to be too bulky. So I just placed these the way I kind of wanted them. The placement that I thought looked best for me. And when I did, I just went ahead and cured that. And then I did the same thing with the glitters. And I feel like I eyeballed this glitter for each color, y'all. I feel like I really nailed it. So let me know in the comments which nail was your favorite and what is your favorite fruit. Let me know down in the comments. What is y'all's favorite fruit? What do y'all like to eat as a fruit snack? Me personally, I like pears, apples, and bananas. Those are my babies. So I will eat those like all the time. I buy for, they're like a dollar or something at Aldi, like a little bag. They're a dollar at Aldi. Like, it's so cheap and easy to eat. Like, I peel it with a potato peeler and my daughter go ham. Like, oh, also grapes. The red grapes, not the greens. The greens are just too sour for me in my taste, but I still like them, but I prefer the red grapes. So those are my favorite fruits. Let me know down in the comments what y'all favorite fruit is. And yeah, let's get back into the set. So I'm just applying the glitter first, still wet, then applying the little fruit slices, and then I cure. And then I kind of went over them with the glitter of each nail, and then I cured again. So I did do those that way. Like I said, I feel like these glitters each matched their polygel, and I feel like I did a really good job at matching the glitters with the polygel. I didn't want them to be, and they are different colors. They're not all the same color. I'm not sure if you guys can clearly see that, but they are different colors. So I'm just putting the fruit slices here. I'm gonna let you guys watch this process. And now that process is all done, they're all cured, I'm gonna go in with my cuticle beads. Now I'm just gonna do the thumb because y'all already know how it goes, the same process. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do my thumb on camera, and then I'll do the rest off camera, just to kind of save some space in my phone and just to kind of cut the repetitive motion out of the video as well. And I heard you guys, I will not cut out the filing. So up after this, you'll see the filing after I do the encapsulation with the clear. I love McCart's clear. It is so beautiful. I actually need to buy some more. We might do that tomorrow. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do my cuticle bead here, and I'm ombreing this into like the fruit slices. It's okay. I didn't want to cover them completely, but they were, you know, gonna be covered. It's just how it goes. That's just what I wanted. Now some people didn't cover theirs, they just had them, you know, up there at the top, but that's how I wanted mine to look, and that's the way I felt it best looking. So I'm just gonna take my clear, you don't need a whole lot, just, you know, little bead right there, and then just go ahead and encap. Make sure you blend first, make sure you wipe off your cuticle bead with alcohol. I did do that off camera as well, because if you don't, sometimes you'll encapsulate that residue white. Don't want to do that. That's a pro tip. With this, I'm just gonna go ahead and encapsulate the nails, and yeah, I'll let you guys watch this process. And this is all the nails encapsulated. So now we're gonna go ahead, look at the application, y'all, beautiful. We're gonna go ahead and do our filing and shaping and buffing. Don't forget to buff y'all's nails. Buffers are really, really cheap. Don't forget to buff y'all's nails. Sometimes I admit I have forgotten to buff my nails. And I'm like, why is my application with my nail art like coming out so trashy? I forgot to buff my nails. I forgot to smooth the surface out to give me a clean, smooth canvas. So don't forget to buff y'all's nails. So we're just going to go ahead and get to shaping and filing. This is self-explanatory, guys. I'm going to go ahead and let you guys watch this process. And if you guys haven't noticed, you're more than halfway through this video. Make sure you guys hit the subscribe button and support your girl for free. And here is all the nails filed, shaped, and buff. I did wipe them down with alcohol. So I'm just gonna go ahead and with my nail art, which is not much, it's just some rhinestones, but they call them crowns or cuticle stones. Just, you know, stones or rhinestones that are crystals or gems, whatever you wanna call them, that are placed around the cuticle area. Just really classy, kind of cute look. Nothing too simple because I really wanted the encapsulation to really shine. So I did use my diamond top coat by Dynamic Nail Supply. I was running out of this one, y'all, so I had to apply it, you know, really weird. But I have a second one, so no need to fear. So I'm just gonna go ahead and apply a good even coat of this diamond top coat. And then I'm just gonna go in with my color to match each finger, and then I'll go in with some ABs as well and just kind of mix the color in and just kind of do some little cute placement there on each finger. This is self-explanatory, but I will let you see every finger that I do, and yeah, I'll let you watch this process. Thank you. And I really just wanted to step in and let you guys know that I appreciate you guys and for clicking on this video. This was such a cute set to make. I really, really love this set. I was so glad that I actually had all these rhinestone different color rhinestones to actually go with this. And I was just like, oh, I have all the stuff. But y'all would be very surprised all the stuff I do have. So yeah, we're going to go ahead and get these final shots. Stick around. And this is how the nails came out. So cute. Like, I love this diamond top coat. Like, it is just one of my favorites. Like, I've used other top coats, but baby, this one right here, Ultimate Shine. Like, I love this top coat. It's so beautiful. Like, it makes everything shine and pop, and especially the clear acrylic where you can see everything. Like, my card's clear. It's just, polygel. I don't know what I was saying. I'm looking at clear acrylic right now for the next set, guys. I'm literally at the nail desk doing my voiceover, so that's why I said that. So I'm always working for you guys. I love doing nails. Like, this is like my passion, my go-to. I really, really love how this set came out. I was so proud of myself for doing this and doing some 3XLs. This is so cute. I hope you guys like this video. I hope you guys love this nail set. Like I said, let me know what your favorite fruit is down in the comments, and I thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye. Why you so fine?